Here we are. Here we are. Yeah. This one right here is for the people.
All right, now, this is Nas featuring Damien, Junior Gong, Marley, Patience, and shout out all the brothers that are fathers, shout out Nas, his son, daughters. I used that in a previous video, so I wasn't able to use it in this one, but that is a good one right there, too, because we're talking about Money YaYa, the current situation she faces with the charges that she has going, along with the situation with her younger sister, whose name we will omit for journalistic integrity, because she is a minor. She kind of spoke out on her social media page, and she kind of gave a cry for help. I want you guys to give this video a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe to my channel, Sherlock Homegirl. Leave your thoughts and opinions below, and tell a friend. Okay, so let's get into it. We're doing a rant and a whine. And basically, I'm posing the question in this one of, is it important to baby your daughters, or is it important to help the man up in a basically manless society? And I want to know how we feel about that. I mean, we're basically having men having to basically be responsible for how much we drink, how much drugs we take. If not, they're going to prison. So a lot of men are choosing to fall back. And this has been happening for a while now. I noticed it as I was in the dating scene. And we saw with the R. Kelly situation, all of the young women who were basically blaming love, hopelessness, being starstruck, the fact that he had money, the fact that he was such a great producer, as enough of an excuse to just basically say this man manipulated their minds and caused them to do some unspeakable acts that they are not too thrilled about. And we know about Money YaYa stabbing LaPatra Jacobs. They were saying twice, but the courts in Florida have petitioned for the hospital records of Miss Jacobs. And it's being said that it's a possible more than two stabbings. Okay, so this girl has multiple stab wounds, possibly. And it's looking like Money YaYa is going to have to serve some type of time. I'm looking like my girl is going to probably get her a lot of speaking engagements on what it is to become a woman. So, her sister, who is 16 and is the daughter of Floyd's, you know, child's mother who passed. And I feel like the baby was just basically speaking out, reaching out as a hint of missing a mother's touch, okay? Because I believe Floyd is kind of tough. And she was saying how, you know, basically by lip syncing to a song, her father found she didn't do anything right. She was not ever beautiful enough or dressed right enough. Nothing was ever perfect. And I feel this child's care, because losing your mother is a very traumatic experience. And I would hope that his mother, an aunt, someone on her mother's side of the family, her grandmother is, they're connecting with her and helping her to feel better, because the toughness of a father is not necessarily a bad thing, okay? And I want you guys to hear me out on this. You know, I love to compare my daddy to Mordecai from the Bible. who raised Queen Esther to where Xerxes would marry her. And right at that point where Esther was, you know, in the kingdom, she was queen, and the king's right-hand man was going to kill all of the Jews, all of her people. Mordecai reached out to her and said, go to your husband and beg him not to kill us. And Mordecai is a tough man now. You got to understand now, the Jews were nobody to play with at that time. The Hebrews themselves in the Bible times were tough people. They had God on their side. They were scouts. They were fighting men. They were farmers. They were scavengers. They were hunters. They were all they needed to be to survive in a tough, tough time. And then they had God on their side. So she sends back and she's basically like, oh, well, I ain't seen him in 30 days. I ain't seen him. I don't know where my husband is, so I don't know what y'all gonna do. Now, the Bible, King James Version, as my father so loves to put it, gives a way more eloquent, poetic, passionate way. But if we want to talk in layman's ghetto terms, I like to translate it as Mordecai sent back to Esther, you tell that bitch, I say, she get in there and tell that man, don't he mess with us, because we gonna survive anyway. And don't get her throat slit in the process of us surviving. Maybe God got her there to save her life. And everybody loves to say to save the people. The people of Israel are gonna be fine with or without Esther. He was saying her life, okay? So, you know, my daddy's tough. You know, he's tough. He gives the world the humble exterior because he understands as a man of God, he has to. But when he comes to us, I'm going to say my daddy ain't with that punk shit. You understand what I'm saying? You need to come with it. What you going to do? You need to have a plan. You need to be executing it. He don't want to hear all this sissy shit. And I hated him for it growing up. But at 38 years old, this is my 38th year on this earth, I have found it to be one of the best assets that I could have had as a woman, is a father's toughness. When men give you that unauthentic masculine bullshit, you can call them on it. That's the reason why with the R. Kelly situation, that Rogers girl whose father told her, I know you ain't gonna mess with no R. Kelly, and she ends up with an STD. Bitch, what did you expect, my friend? You know, and Money YaYa, I feel, has had a tough dad, but she chose a tough road. And I feel like it's too much to continue to blame men every time we mess up. I've had to face a lot of facts about my life. And my taste in men is one of those things. And I've had to redirect myself, regroom myself, reteach myself a lot of things, because you will take a good man and teach him a lot of tragic, trifling shit that you learn from a trifling dude that he know he can get away with you. And these people go get with somebody else and they don't even put these females through that. So sometimes you gotta face the facts about what it is about you. Like Cat Williams says, what it is about your pussy that don't like, you know, good men. And change that about yourself. Change it, you know. I feel like the situation with Money YaYa, I feel like my girl got what she was looking for. You know, it's getting ready to be hot. If Big Rona wasn't out there prior to a lot of people getting sick, because I know the cases in my hometown of Tallulah are higher than they're letting us know. However, I do also know that they were fighting and doing a lot of crazy stuff prior to getting ill from it. And truth be told about the situation, y'all don't need to be out there fighting over these dudes. It's not worth it. I personally leave a man when he shows me another woman is able to penetrate. Like, if I'm able to break into his house, they say she broke into his home. So it wasn't like she came through the front door. They're saying he told her not to come. She came. He put her out. She broke in. This bitch is finna go to prison. Broke in and stabbed this girl multiple times. So she's saying it was self-defense. The girl pulled her hair. Nah, boo. Nah. Because if it was self-defense, why you ain't leave the man's home? Then you were back in his home soon as you got out of prison and your daddy posted your bond. Now, my daddy would let me sit there. So that's why I say Floyd ain't as tough as everybody's trying to give him. I think he has created little monsters, girls that he can't control by pampering them and babying them and giving them lavish lifestyles. And they're upset about everything. And I understand my young baby being upset about her mom. We all need to pray for her. Because life will only get harder after that. And that's why I tell my kids all the time, prepare. Prepare as if I'm never going to be here. Because you don't know. You don't know. And I want to know what you guys think about it. Leave your thoughts and opinions below. Make sure you subscribe to Sherlock Homegirl. We're going to be talking about a lot of other situations, the COVID-19, more of my comments from my subscribers who will comment. So I hope you will be one of them. And thank you to all of you. Peace.